I come to preach the gospel to you today about Jesus Christ. Today is Sunday. This is the day that Jesus rose again from the dead. It's not Sunday fun day. You see, God created you for the purpose that you would be a vessel for Him. You see, God gives every single person a free choice, a free will. And you came into this earth, you can either choose to go two roads. The Bible speaks of a broad, wide way that many will go. But the broad path, the wide gate, it leads to destruction. And there is also a straight, narrow way that leads to life. You see, life is more than just trying to climb the corporate ladder. It's more than trying to buy the new car, the new phone, just trying to build your 401k. It's more than just trying to pursue the toys in life. But you are created in the image of God with the purpose that you might have life in Christ, that you might have fulfillment. Because people will never be satisfied as long as they're looking for materialism. They're looking for relationships to fill a void. You see, God created that void in you, and only Jesus Christ can fill that today. You see, but there's an issue. There's a thing called sin. In the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve sinned, and they were separated from God because God is holy. So the question I pose to you today is, what are you going to do with sin? Because sin has to be accounted for. And sin is transgression. The Bible says, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And I want to ask you a question. Have you ever told a lie? You say, well, who doesn't tell a lie? The Bible says no liar will go to heaven. The Bible also says if you look on someone with lust, that you've committed adultery in your heart. Now that would be many people if I asked you to raise your hand today, but let me tell you, you don't have to stay in a place of condemnation because Jesus can pay your fine. Jesus can cause you to escape from the punishment that will come upon all the ungodly, all those that practice unrighteousness. Jesus is the straight, narrow way that leads to life. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no man comes to the Father but by me. Some of you are trying to go another way. Some of you trust in religion. You go to church once a week, but that's not enough. Because you have to have a born-again, abiding relationship with Jesus, or it doesn't mean anything. Because you're not going to come on your own terms. You're not going to be able to prove your goodness to God. You have to come through the door of Jesus by faith in Him. You have to deny this world. The Bible says to pick up your cross and follow Him. The Bible says clearly that God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, that shall he also reap. If you plant an apple seed in a field, you do not expect to see an orange tree develop because of the life that is in that seed. And today, if you are practicing ungodliness and unrighteousness, be sure that the seed of God, that the righteousness of God is not in your life. Because the Bible says, by their fruits you shall know them. And the Bible says, he that saith, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. Today, if you're looking at pornography, today, if you're watching rated R movies, you're listening to rap music, you're listening to rock and roll, you're watching all kinds of wicked things on your television, rapes and murders, and you're entertained by those things, that should let you know that the fruit of your life is opposite of a love for God. You actually, in turn, are following another person called the devil. Jesus told many in his day that you're following your father, the devil, because the devil is the prince and power of the air. The devil wants you to think that the party is going to keep going, that there's not going to be a consequence for drunkenness, for lying, for stealing. There's not going to be a consequence for profanity. But sin always destroys. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. I preach to you today the power of Jesus Christ to break chains, to break addictions, to break you off Vicodin, to break you off antidepressants. There's a lot of people that have large homes, 5,000 square foot homes. They have yachts, but they take antidepressants because they don't have peace. They don't have the answer for panic attacks. They don't have the answer for suicidal thoughts. But Jesus today can break you out of addictions, break you out of that porn addiction, break you out of living in fornication, sleeping around, Jesus can give you a peace. He can give you a life. Your life is not meant to just exist or to float through life. You see, only God can fill that need in your life. Many people, they follow society. They sleep from one bed to the next, one relationship to the next, one broken heart to the next. Today is Valentine's Day. But let me tell you, only God can really teach you what love is. Because Jesus is the love of God. Most of y'all only know lust. If it feels good, do it. You go by your feelings. But you know what? The problem is you get your feelings a lot of times before a commitment. You go outside of God's arranged plan. You see, God has a plan for a husband and a wife, a man and a woman. There's no such things as homosexual marriage, a man and a man. There's no such thing as transgenderism. There's no such thing as those false confusion that the devil promotes, because that is wickedness. And God made a man and a woman. And God is also against abortion. Abortion is murder. And God can forgive you if you have committed an abortion, or maybe you supported your girlfriend or boyfriend in this issue, then you're guilty of that as well. I want to tell you today that God will always judge for the blood of the innocents. This land is filled with over 60 million babies' blood because of convenience. People don't want to ruin their career. They don't want to ruin their college. They just want to get rid of this inconvenience called a baby. And some of you under the sound of my voice, you've done this. Now I'm just telling you, if you'll repent today, God can cleanse you and have mercy on you. But if you choose to make excuses, the Bible says no murder will go to heaven. Now it's good news today if you love the truth. If today you don't have a love for God, you love the world, you love seeking after materialism, you like to cover over sin, then you're probably not going to like the light of the truth of the gospel that's going out. But it's good news if you know that Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners. He came to deliver people, to give them a hope and a future. He came to deliver them from drunkenness. The Bible says no drunkard's going to go to heaven. Some people say, well, I don't get drunk. Well, the Bible says if you're tipsy, if you're under the influence, that's the same thing as being drunk. A lot of people want to make excuses and justify their position, but God's word maintains a firm stance. If you'll come to the light of God's word and be honest and say, God, I need help. You can't overcome the devices and snares of the devil. You can't just go to your psychiatrist and get a prescribed drug to try to cure you of being bitter and being a person that has hatred for people. Some of you can't control a violent temper. It's because that anger is just rolling and rolling and you can't do anything about it. You know why? It's not just because that's the way your parents were. Yes, that gets passed. There are generational issues. There are generational sins. But the reason is just this. Your heart needs to be changed. That's why I use profanity. It's because that's what's inside of you. If you watch movies that are cursing every other word, mocking God, you watch rapes on your television, you watch people that are committing adultery, it's a sad state because you're entertained by that. The Bible speaks in Romans 1 that many would do these kind of things and be entertained by this. You see, there's a certain judgment that's coming for all those that are entertained by sin and have pleasure in unrighteousness. God is true, and let every man be a liar. I preach to you the word of God. The word of God is a firm foundation. Jesus Christ is the word of God. And not one jot, not one tittle, not one little punctuation point will ever fade from the God's word. Some of you put more trust in Fox News, in CNN. You put more trust in what Bill Gates or some quack on a television says, and you don't believe the word of God. You'll believe the National Enquirer before you'll believe God's word. You know what that is? That's just called a strong defense for sin. Because men will do irrational things to try to defend their position. And especially when you have to answer before a holy God, and you're going to be judged for fornication, sleeping around, not being married. You're going to be judged for being disobedient to your parents. You're going to be judged for drinking alcohol. You're going to be judged for lying. If you're a Freemason tonight, you're a devil worshiper. You're in the occult. You can keep that secret over on the side. You can think that it's just a way to elevate yourself in society, but make no doubt about it, you're following a fallen kingdom called the devil's kingdom. If today you are involved in the occult, you're practicing astrology, horoscopes, some of you are entertained by horror movies, you're allowing the devil a free road into your life. Do you wonder why people have unexplained deaths sometimes in a family? Do you wonder why people battle with certain vices? It's because there are certain strongholds in lives that need to be broken. Some of you